Well, good Thursday morning, friends. Mark Holmes here with my buddy Cowboy Joe Boo, as well as Joe Bear in the house. And as always, I want to say thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Joe Boo Sports Report. Without you guys, as well as you ladies, you know that this literally does not work. So let's get open for business here, and let's wake up the football gods. Good morning, guys. How's everybody doing here? We are on the last Thursday night football game with the Dallas Cowboys versus the Tennessee Titans. The Thursday night package hasn't been all that Amazon had hoped it would be, but maybe getting them boys on Thursday night will give them a big boost, because we know that the Dallas Cowboys, a team that's had more fans in the stands, the team that has the biggest watched games in the NFL, the team that has the biggest number of fans, and the team with the biggest number of haters out there, definitely can give Amazon Prime a boost. Amazon Prime is actually, Amazon is talking about making Thursday Night Football a standalone app as opposed to it being part of Amazon Prime. They said they're not finished fixing the baby just yet, that they still have more things that they want to do with it, and we'll see what they actually do with it. So with that being said, we play the Tennessee Titans that will not have Derrick Henry playing tonight. The reality is the Tennessee Titans are looking at this game saying it doesn't matter. If we win, it still does not mean anything for us for playoffs. If we lose, it still does not mean anything for playoffs. They are looking and saying everything comes down to playing the Jacksonville Jaguars next week. And so anybody who is nicked up, dinged up, and possibly needed for that Jags game is not playing tonight. So we end up having backup rookie quarterback Malik Willis is starting. We have running back Hassan Hankins. I know you're like, who? Yeah, that's exactly what I said. Hassan Hankins. Now, Hankins, let's be clear here. Hankins has been on their practice squad. He has played in two games. And in his NFL career, he has an incredible average. 4.5 yards per carry and 4.4 yards per reception. Now, mind you, he's only had 11 carries and 50 yards, and he's had 7 receptions for 31 yards. But be that as it may, the averages are really, really good. So for the Cowboys, Dak says, basically, I don't give a rat's ass. That's not the exact words, but he doesn't give a rat's ass about what Tennessee does. We're getting ready for playoffs, and we're going out to get a win, which, of course, worries me, because now, you know, whenever it seems like we have a game that should be an easy game, somehow it gets to be a little difficult. But the Cowboys are double-digit favorites going against the Titans tonight. I just want to remind you guys of something here, because we have so many people out there that hate Dak Prescott, and it's crazy. It's crazy. After the Eagles game, I saw the Eagle fan that by now everybody has seen and nobody knows who he is, but this Eagle fan that has taken football beyond where it should be. You know, yesterday was kind of cool to me. I was up in Delaware, had to go to Hardware Store and get a plug for a dryer, and I go in there with people I've never seen before, don't know anything about them, and we got talking about football. And I joked and said, oh, man, well, I'm a Cowboys fan. I can't get this hot sauce. It's for Eagles. Like, oh, I knew there was something about you. But it turns out he was an old school Washington fan. And we struck up a conversation about football and things. We talked for about 10 minutes. Like, well, I got to go back and get some work done. But it's amazing how football used to be something that would bring people together. But seeing this guy who literally said, you know, I'm glad your mother's dead. I'm glad your brother's dead. I hope Tad's next. And then followed it up with a video of getting a sweatshirt saying, you know, my mom gave it to me. And, you know, isn't it nice to have a mom? Goes to show you what low life people are in the world. And I'm not going to say that this is new, Unfortunately, now because of social media, it gives people the platform to hate. And unfortunately, we miss all of the good things because everybody likes something negative. I posted this on Twitter saying, what is wrong with people? My thing is trying to lower the temperature and understand, you know, me and Philly 500 should be a microcosm of the way it is in football. He loves his team. I love my team, you know, and we can be friends. But so many people have this hatred. And it's crazy because here it is. Somebody says something that is just crazy, just way out of bounds. And other people are like, yeah, I hope you're next. I hope I'm next. You really wish that I die? And I go back to say, what's wrong with people? But there's also people that swear that Dak Prescott is inaccurate. Dak Prescott sucks. Even though we just see record after record of the Dallas Cowboys being broken, you know, back-to-back winning seasons, back-to-back playoff seasons, you know, things that the Cowboys have not done since the 90s on a regular basis, destroying your division. And he gets so much hate. And they talk about his accuracy not being there. I'm going to go ahead and say, because here's where it's really and truly crazy is, you get people that say, oh, well, it's 3rd and 30. They got lucky. Lucky? Dude, this is the Hail Mary. Was that just lucky? Or was it two guys that got their shit together and made a perfect play? Because if you talk about accuracy, you talk about interceptions. Take a look at this play again. Just take a look at it. Looks it off, throws it, boom, to the spot. Right there. He didn't have to stretch for it. He didn't have to jump for it. The defender couldn't get it. Are you kidding me? That's not a duck flying through there. I'm still mystified how people can say, no, Dak sucks. He's not the one. We need to draft somebody else. I'm going to ask you, what else could he have done to make that any better? What else could T.Y. Hilton have done to make that any better? 52-yard pass completion. Because I keep hearing about his air yards, his accuracy. That's 52 yards. Look at that. I know haters that's like a knife to the gut right now. Just seeing that. Sorry. You're full of shit. Y'all are full of shit. All right, so let's go to NFL Network this morning and hear who's in and who's out for this game. It'll be easier for me to do it that way. And of course, let's get the haters.
Playoff picture. Let's just lay this one out. The NFC playoff picture, the page in front of me, it's like two pages long. The NFC South in itself has a half a page.
Hell yeah.
It's very complicated. The Cowboys currently are the 5 seed, though, with a shot at stealing the NFC East from the Eagles. Here we go. If Dallas wins out and Philly drops their last two, the Cowboys are division champs, and the Eagles drop to 5th. Uh-huh. But all of that becomes a moot point if the Cowboys lose to the Titans on Thursday Night Football. Cue the AFC playoff picture. Speaking of those Titans, they're lurking at the 10th seed in the AFC. Tonight's game will have virtually no bearing on their playoff chances.
None.
That should come down to week 18 in Jacksonville, where the winner would take the AFC South, the 4th seed, and win a home playoff game, of course, barring any ties. No more ties. Ties are done for the last 2 weeks.
We're getting some ties this week.
Okay? So we wanted to set the table before we brought in our NFL Network insider, Tom Pelissero, for some news on some players that we may or may not see tonight. Tom, what's up?
Well, Jamie, Titans star running back Derrick Henry officially listed as doubtful for tonight's game against the Cowboys. Mm-hmm. Not expected to play in this one. My understanding is this is precautionary for Derrick Henry, who was limited in practice this week because of a hip issue. This game doesn't actually matter in terms of the AFC South standings. It's also a short week, so they're going to hold Henry back here full expectation he will be back out there for the division title game next week against the Jaguars. For tonight, it's going to be Hassan Haskins, the rookie fourth-round draft pick out of Michigan, who is in line for a big role for the Titans, and I'm sure plenty of fantasy football teams as well. Cowboys also have some injury questions coming into this one. Linebacker Micah Parsons and running back Tony Pollard, both listed as questionable. Parsons should be good to go. Limited in practice this week because of a hand issue. There's less certainty with Tony Pollard, who's been dealing with a thigh. They got to see how he feels today. This one potentially could come down to a pregame workout to determine if Pollard is ready to go. Jamie?
That piques some interest, too, from more than just a fantasy football perspective for some guys. Tony Pollard, interesting, going right up to game time in Nashville tonight. Tom Pelissero, thank you very much. All right, guys, it's the final Thursday Night Football game of the season, coming to you live from Nashville, Tennessee. What's to look forward to when the Cowboys take on the Titans, Jason, in this one?
All right, there we go.
Yeah, four.
That's it.
Yeah, four. That's it.
There you go with your preview of the Dallas Cowboys versus the Tennessee Titans. And I don't know about you, but I am ready. I am fully ready for the game. I'm going to be getting ready for our, we're doing a Nashville spicy chicken sandwich. We're going to Jobuize it. It is literally a fried chicken sandwich with a hot sauce paste that we're going to Jobu, you know, hot wing sauce it up and make it just right for this thing tonight with a cabbage lettuce slaw on top of it and a spicy mayo. Oh, and it's going to be kicking. It's going to be kicking. So tune in tonight. If you want to know the recipe, I'll have it up tomorrow on exactly what we're going to do on my cooking and tailgating with Jobu YouTube channel. And if you want to know how we've done any of our game day subs and stuff, all of those recipes are on there as well. All right, good people, we are going to get out of here and we got work to do. As always, you know how we roll.
Mark Holmes here, and as always, I want to thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Jobu Sports Report.
And all the thing else I got to say is, how about this now? Yeah!